Good morning, everyone. In this lesson, we are going to study about automatic gain control, choice of IF, and AM demodulation. The various outcomes of the lesson are reasons for use and functions of RF amplifier, choice of IF, automatic gain control, AGC, or automatic volume control, AVC, and processor for demodulation in AM. In the previous topic, we have learned about heterodyne process. Practically all receivers today are super heterodyne. The basic disadvantage of TRF receiver is its varying amplification and selectivity. This problem is solved if one single frequency was always to be received, because the receiver could be designed to have maximum amplification and good selectivity at that frequency. While the super heterodyne receiver system is more complicated than TRF, the ability to operate satisfactorily on any frequency with a constant value of selectivity and good sensitivity makes it highly desirable. So super heterodyne receivers makes use of the principle of heterodyning. Super heterodyne receiver, the incoming signal, that is RF signal, is converted into a standard IF frequency before detection takes place. This is done with the help of mixing RF frequency converter. Heterodyne means mixing. In super heterodyne receiver, the incoming signal is combined with the local oscillator signal and converted into a signal of lower fixed frequency. The fixed frequency signal is called the intermediate frequency signal and contains the same modulation as the original carrier. Thus, the heterodyne process involves a simple change or translation of carrier frequency. That means the message which is there on the received RF signal is placed onto the IF signal. Suppose that the carrier of the frequency is heterodyne with another frequency, local oscillator frequency F0. That is, the incoming signal frequency FS is combined with local oscillator frequency F0. Then we are getting F0 plus FF, the sum component, F0 minus FS, the difference component. Usually the sum frequency is removed by bandpass filtering. The different frequency is retained and forms the IF frequency in AM receivers. The IF frequency of AM receiver is 455 kHz. Suppose in AM, the modulated message signal of frequency 1500 kHz is mixed with unmodulated carrier by local oscillator of frequency 1955. That means the local oscillator will always produce a frequency higher by an amount of IF. If the incoming signal frequency is 1500 kHz, local oscillator is simultaneously tuned to 1500 kHz plus 455 kHz. Then we will be getting the addition and difference of frequencies, that is 1500 plus 1955 kHz and 1955 minus 1500 kHz, which is equal to 455 kHz. The addition frequencies are generally filtered out. That IF 455 kHz is available as output of mixer, which is called as intermediate frequency. Since this frequency is lower than the signal frequency, but still above the range of audio frequencies, hence it is called as intermediate frequency. The intermediate frequency carrier has the same intelligence as the original incoming RF signal, but only the frequency of the carrier is changed. That is the main advantage. Advantage is selectivity is improved, better sensitivity, better fidelity. Sensitivity is the ability of the radio receiver to amplify the weak signals. How much minimum voltage that we apply at the input of the receiver in order to get a standard output is the term related to sensitivity. Selectivity is the ability of the radio receiver to pick up the wanted signal and to reject the unwanted signal. So we'll be getting good selectivity using the Super 8 Rodin process. Then the next one is the fidelity. It is the faithful reproduction of all frequency components present in the message signal. So fidelity is also improved in a Super 8 Rodin receiver. The incoming RF signal, regardless of the frequency, are converted to IF frequency. Thus, the signal amplification takes place before detection is always accomplished at the same frequency. Thus, we have common circuits after mixer, irrespective of the channel frequency or received. And hence, we have the various blocks, the receiving antenna, RF amplifier, frequency converter or mixer, IF amplifier, detector, audio amplifier, power amplifier, and loudspeaker. The receiving antenna is used to pick up the electromagnetic wave and convert it into RF signal. This signal voltage is applied to RF amplifier. RF amplifier, this is generally voltage amplifier tuned to the desired frequency. The functions of RF amplifier are to amplify the incoming signal that is induced into the input of RF amplifier through the antenna, to reject the interference such as image frequency, and to reduce the noise figure of the receiver and to improve the signal to noise ratio. Frequency converter or a mixer stage. This consists of local oscillator and a frequency mixer. The local oscillator produces frequency higher by IF value than the incoming signal frequency. For example, if the selected incoming radio frequency is 1000 kHz, the local oscillator is simultaneously tuned to 1455 kHz in case of AM receiver. The selected radio frequency signal and the signal produced by local oscillator are applied to the mixer. The mixer produces a frequency equal to the difference between the local oscillator and the incoming radio signal frequency. This is called intermediate frequency, and it is 455 kHz in case of AM receivers. The next stage is the IF amplifier stage. As we discussed, the output of the mixer is the IF frequency and is applied to IF amplifier. This signal is amplified by a chain of two or more fixed frequency amplifiers. The IF amplifier provides most of the gain and bandwidth requirements of the receiver. The next stage is the detector or demodulator. The output of the last IF stage is fed to the detector. The detector recovers the original message signal from the modulated signal, which is an IF. The detector also supplies DC bias to the RF and IF stages in the form of automatic gain control circuits. The detected signal is applied to audio amplifier. The message signal recovered is applied to audio amplifier to get the sufficient amplification. Then it is applied to power amplifier. The output of the audio amplifier is given to the power amplifier to raise the power level of the message signal to the sufficient value. And finally, it is applied to loudspeaker. The amplified message signal is fed to the loudspeaker. The loudspeaker reproduces original sound, which is transmitted from transmitter. The various advantages of the Super 8 Rodin receiver are uniform selectivity and sensitivity throughout the tuning band. No variation in bandwidth over the tuning range, sufficient adjacent channel frequency rejection, good fidelity. Because of all these advantages, nowadays we are making use of Super 8 Rodin receiver in almost all receiver applications. The various applications of Super 8 Rodin receiver are AM broadcasting receiver, FM broadcast receiver, television receiver, communication receiver, ISB receiver, SSB receiver, and radio receivers. So in almost all applications, we are making use of Super 8 Rodin receiver because of all the advantages. Now we'll say about the reasons for use and functions of RF amplifier. This is also one of the blocks in super heterodyne receiver. Immediately after antenna, we have the RF amplifier. Why we are using this RF amplifier and what are the various functions of the RF amplifier. The first one is the greater gain, that is better sensitivity. If there is an RF amplifier, we will be getting the better sensitivity. The second function is the improved sensitivity, signal to noise ratio. Signal to noise ratio is improved, so we will be getting better clarity at output. Improved image frequency rejection. Better selectivity, that is improved rejection of adjacent unwanted signals. Better coupling of receiver to antenna. So it acts as an impedance matching device between antenna and the next stage. Prevention of re-radiation of local oscillator through antenna of the receiver. If there is no RF amplifier, the local oscillator that is applied to the mixer may go towards the antenna, and then antenna will radiate the signal instead of receiving the signal. So it prevents re-radiation of the local oscillator through an antenna of receiver. Because of all these advantages, we are supposed to use RF amplifier. Not only that, the input to the RF amplifier is a tuned circuit. For picking up the desired signal, we must use the tuned RF amplifier. Now we'll see the choice of IF. IF is generally chosen to be lower than the lowest signal frequency. Lower the IF, easier is to obtain the selectivity needed to reject the adjacent signal. If the IF is too high, poor selectivity and poor adjacent channel rejection. Hence, the intermediate frequency of the receiving system is usually a compromise. So the first task of the IF stage is to eliminate the sound frequency. Only the difference frequency is designed as it denotes the IF to which the receiver is designed. The IF stage is a bandpass filter centered around IF. The ability of the IF stage to reject the undesired sound signal from the mixer depends on how sharply the bandpass filter rolls up from the center frequency. So the function of the bandpass filter is to select the difference frequency. That means that is the IF frequency, it need to be selected. Standard AM broadcast receiver uses 455 kHz as the IF. The receiver is tuned across the entire band. The AM radio broadcasting band is from 530 kHz to 1640 kHz. So this entire frequency band is to be picked up by the radio receiver. For the signal tuned, the radio receiver must be able to produce all the functions of the receiver. The IF stage filtering must pass the 455 kHz signal while rejecting all some signals, and also the unwanted harmonic frequencies are also to be removed. The bandwidth of the bandpass filter must be slightly wider than the bandwidth of the information signal. Information signal is a message signal. So bandwidth of the bandpass filter should be slightly high so that all the message signal should be passed by the bandpass filter. So we are making the bandpass filter such that its bandwidth is higher than the bandwidth of the message signal. For standard AM radio broadcast, the IF stage has to pass 10 kHz signal centered on 455 kHz while rejecting the signals outside that span. That means the message is placed onto 455 kHz IF. By the process of super heterodyning, the modulation products which are there on the received incoming signal are placed on 455 kHz. The message signal is of bandwidth 10 kHz. So it occupies 5 kiloheads on either side centered at 455 kiloheads. That means 455 minus 5 kiloheads, 455 plus 5 kiloheads. So we will be getting that particular band through the IF stage. So IF amplifier, it has to amplify 455 kiloheads and its band of 10 kiloheads centered on either side while rejecting the signals outside that particular span. So as we see, this antenna picks up the RF signal. Amplifier, RF amplifier is used to raise the power level. Received incoming signal strength is weakened strength, and hence it has to amplify. It has to pick up the particular signal. This incoming FS signal is combined with the local oscillator signal in the mixer or frequency changer. Here we are getting the intermediate frequency signal, and this intermediate frequency signal is a 455 kilohertz, and it has to amplify 455 kilohertz and a band of 10 kilohertz. And it is applied to a detector to demodulate the signal, recover the original message signal, and then apply to the audio amplifier to increase the power level, voltage level, and also the power amplifier to increase the power level. And it is applied to the speaker or headphone to recover back the original sound. So the choice of IF, how much will be the IF frequency? How much frequency will be selected by the bandpass filter? It is based upon a certain parameter. Even though super heterodyne receiver provides so many advantages, there is a problem with image frequency. It is an unwanted frequency that is picked up by the receiver. Now we will define image frequency. It is possible for an unwanted RF signal to get through the RF amplifier, mix with the desired signal at the IF to be amplified. So it is an unwanted RF amplifier that is coming through the RF amplifier that will be mixed with the desired signal at the IF stage. That undesired signal is also amplified, and it is the unwanted signal. The unwanted signal, which appears like a mirror reflected image to the original signal, is known as image frequency signal. An image frequency signal is one that is at the same distance from the local oscillator frequency as the desired signal, but in the opposite direction. The image signal also gets amplified by the IF stage along with the original signal and causes interference. This has the effect of two stations being received simultaneously and is undesirable. This image frequency is undesirable. That is also picked up because we have wide tuning range of 530 kilohertz to 1640 kilohertz. When we are picking up the wanted signal, there may be the choice of inducing the image frequency at the input side. Thereby, it also gets amplified by the IF stage along with the original signal, and it causes the interference, and hence this is to be minimized. What is the problem of this image frequency? The reason is this has the effect of two stations being received simultaneously and is undesirable. In standard broadcast receiver, the local oscillator is made higher than the incoming signal frequency. It is made equal to the signal frequency plus the intermediate frequency. And hence, the local oscillator frequency equal to signal frequency FS plus intermediate frequency FI. From this, we are getting signal frequency FS equal to F0 minus FI. When FS and FS are F0 are mixed in the difference frequency called intermediate frequency is resulted, as it only passing and amplified by the IF stage. If the image frequency FSI manages to reach the mixer, what is image frequency? F naught plus FI is the image frequency. F naught is the local oscillator frequency plus FI is the intermediate frequency. That is also passing through the IF amplifier. So this spurious intermediate frequency signal is able to be amplified by the IF stage and will produce interference. This has the effect of two stations being received simultaneously and is undesirable. The signal undesirable signal frequency is called image frequency and is defined as the signal local oscillator frequency plus intermediate frequency, or it is defined as the signal frequency plus twice the intermediate frequency. When the oscillator operating at a frequency higher than the desired RF signal, the image frequency is given by the formula FSI. FSI is the image frequency, which is equal to signal frequency plus 2 times the intermediate frequency. This may also be picked up by the radio receiver. This is the undesired signal. In a standard broadcast receiver, the local oscillator frequency is made higher than the incoming signal frequency. That is, F0 is equal to FS plus FI. FS is equal to F0 minus FI. The image signal is greater than the local oscillator frequency by IF value. So we have image frequency equal to F0 plus FI, but F0 equal to FS plus FI. Plus already FI is there, so we are getting FS plus 2 times FI. And hence the image frequency is equal to signal frequency plus 2 times the intermediate frequency. Where FSI is called the image frequency, FS is called the signal frequency, FI is called the intermediate frequency. For example, suppose the receiver is tuned to 1000 kilohertz. 1000 kilohertz plus 2 times 455 kilohertz is also available at the input of the radio receiver. That is also induced into the receiver. That channel is also interfering with the wanted 1000 kilohertz signal. That unwanted, undesired signal, we call it as the image frequency, and it must be avoided. For removing image frequency, we are making use of image frequency rejection ratio. The rejection of the image frequency, there is a formula. It is defined as the ratio of gain at signal frequency to the gain at image frequency. And hence, image frequency rejection ratio alpha equal to gain at signal frequency divided by gain at image frequency. Gain at signal frequency will be higher. If we are able to provide gain at signal frequency higher, or if we are able to provide gain at image frequency lower, then that ratio will be improved and it has minimum effect on the wanted signal. And hence, this is one of the very important parameter, and it can be represented by using the formula image frequency rejection ratio alpha equal to square root of 1 plus Q square rho square, where rho is FSI by FS minus FS by FSI, and Q is the loaded quality factor of the tank circuit. So we are supposed to minimize the effect of image frequency. So in order to minimize the effect of image frequency, we are going for image frequency rejection ratio. So it is defined as the ratio of gain at signal frequency to the gain at image frequency. So that ratio to be improved, the rejection of the image frequency is given by the formula alpha equal to root of 1 plus Q square rho square. Q Q is related to the quality factor of the antenna coupling circuit, and rho is the parameter related to image frequency and the signal frequency given by the formula rho equal to FSI by FS minus FS by FSI. Calculate the value of rho using this formula. Q is the loaded quality factor of the tuned circuit and calculate it, and we will be getting the image frequency rejection ratio. So image rejection depends on the front end selectivity of the receiver, and it must be achieved before the IF stage. Now we'll see the applications of the Super 8 Rhodyne receiver. It is widely used in AM broadcasting receivers. AM broadcast band is from 530 to 1640 kilohertz. So the AM Super 8 Rhodyne receivers are most widely used in broadcast receivers. Super 8 Rhodyne receivers are also used in FM broadcast receivers. Super 8 Rhodyne principle is also used in TV receiver, communication sophisticated receivers, and radar receivers also makes use of the principle of Super 8 Rhodyne. Independent sideband and single sideband receivers also makes use of the Super 8 Rhodyne principle. Hence, the Super 8 Rhodyne principle is very important concept in order to provide better sensitivity, selectivity, fidelity, and improved AGC, reduction of the fading effects, etc. Satellite receivers also makes use of the Super 8 Rhodyne principle. All modern receivers of various applications employ Super 8 Rhodyne procedure. So Super 8 Rhodyne procedure is used to get the receiver principle. Now let us see the factors influencing the choice of the IF. The selection of a particular IF while designing a receiving system is usually a compromise between high image rejection ratio and at the same time good adjacent channel selectivity. It has to reject the image frequency, and at the same time it has to select the wanted signal and to remove the unwanted nearby stations. The main factors influencing the choice of IF in any particular system are: if the IF is too high, if you provide the IF value too high, selectivity becomes poor and sharp cutoff filters are to be used. There is a problem if IF is too high, if it is far more than 455 kilohertz, selectivity is becoming poor and sharp cutoff filters are to be used. Otherwise, it results in poor adjacent channel rejection. A high value of IF increases tracking difficulties. Tracking means selecting, tuning the particular channel will be difficult if the value of IF is high. As the IF is lower, image frequency rejection becomes poor. A very low IF makes selectivity too sharp, that results in cutting of the sidebands. If the IF is very low, the frequency stability of the local oscillator must be made correspondingly higher. So keeping in view of all these parameters, we have to keep the IF value. The IF value should not fall within the tuning range of the receiver, or else instability will occur and Rhodyne whistles will be heard at the loudspeaker. Poor selectivity and poor adjacent channel rejection are the disadvantages with high intermediate frequency value. So IF is generally chosen to be lower than the lowest signal frequency. Lower the IF, easier to obtain the selectivity needed to reject the adjacent signal. If the IF is too high, poor selectivity and poor adjacent channel rejection, Hence, the intermediate frequency of the receiving system is usually a compromise. The various factors that we need to consider while selecting the IF value are: if the IF is too high, poor selectivity and poor adjacent channel rejection, a high value of intermediate frequency is lower, the image frequency becomes poorer. As the intermediate frequency is still lower, image frequency becomes poorer. A very low IF value can make use the selectivity too sharp, cutting of the sidebands. This problem arises because of a quality factor must be low when the IF is low. Hence, it is required to raise the Q. If the IF value is very low, the frequency stability of the local oscillator must be made correspondingly higher. The IF should not fall within the tuning range of the receiver, or else the instability will occur and heterodyne whistles will be heard, making it possible to tune to the impossible to tune to the frequency and immediately adjacent to the intermediate frequency. So poor selectivity, poor adjacent channel rejection are the disadvantages with higher intermediate frequency value. So proper selection of the IF is very important. And we have IF values for different systems. IF should neither be too low nor too high because of all the reasons as we discussed. An optimum value of IF has to be selected based on the required application. Standard broadcast AM receivers, which are in the tuning range from 530 kHz to 1640 kHz, uses an IF value of 455 kHz. At 455 kHz, all the problems which we have discussed are to be minimized. So it is selected as 455 kHz. An SSB, AM and other receivers used for shortwave communication or VHF reception have first IF in the range from 1.6 MHz to 2.3 MHz. By keeping in view of all these parameters, the different values of IF are selected for different type of receiver systems. FM receivers using the standard 88 MHz to 108 MHz band uses an IF value of 10.7 MHz. Television receivers in the VHF band, that is 54 MHz to 233 MHz, and the UHF band 470 MHz to 940 MHz use an IF value between 26 MHz and 46 MHz. We have microwave receivers, radar receivers operating in the frequency range from 1 to 10 GHz uses IF depending on the application either 30 MHz or 60 MHz or 70 MHz are most popularly used IF values for microwave, radar or receivers. So most widely used values are given here. And hence selection of the IF value is particularly important. Now we'll say about the functions of automatic volume control, AVC, or automatic gain control, AGC. Automatic gain control or automatic volume control is a system by means of which the overall gain of a radio receiver is varied automatically with the changing strength of the received signal to keep the output always constant. So AGC or AVC is a system by means of which the overall gain of a receiver is varied automatically with the changing strength of the received signal to keep the output always constant. AGC maintains the level of the output audio signal almost constant in spite of large variations of input modulated signals. What is the need for AGC? The task of the receiver circuit is complicated by the fact that the received signal level is not constant but varies constantly due to fading. What is fading? Where is fading? Is the fluctuations in the received signal strength. Because the signal is received through multiple paths, there is a delay in receiving the signal. So different waves coming from the transmitter are delayed Due to that, there will be fading. When there is a fading, there are fluctuations in the received signal strength. Due to that, the signal is not constant at the output of the receiver. And hence, we need an AGC system. For the minimum signal at the input of the receiver, loudspeaker output becomes inaudible. For the maximum input signal, loudspeaker output becomes intolerably large, because there is so much of variation is there in the output quality. That is the reason we have to keep the maintain. We have to maintain the output always constant with the changing strength of the received signal. So AGC is used. Essentially, an AGC circuit receives a sinusoidal input signal such as AM wave and delivers a DC output signal whose amplitude is proportional to the amplitude of the input signal. The DC output is usually a negative voltage, but in transistorized equipment, it can be a positive. Now we'll see the description of the AGC. The greater the amplitude of AC input, the larger the DC output. The smaller the amplitude of the AC input, the smaller the DC output. An important characteristic of AGC circuit is that it does not respond to the instantaneous amplitude variations of the AC input signal. This is the circuit diagram of AVC, automatic volume control. We have a tuned circuit, IF transformer. Then we have a diode connected in the reverse mode. Then we have the low pass filter. Then we are recovering a low frequency signal. Then that is amplified by using audio frequency amplifier. Then we derive the AGC. While demodulating the signal, this is a diode detector. While demodulating the signal, we are also picking up the signal that is applied as an input to the previous circuits. It acts as an automatic gain control. This is the characteristics of the AVC. This is the received output voltage versus incoming signal strength. As signal strength increases, receiver output voltage also increases. If we have simple AGC, the curve is like this. If it is delayed AGC, the curve is like this. No AGC. We want always a constant output. This is desirable. A constant output is required irrespective of the variations in the incoming signal strength. On x-axis, we have incoming signal strength variations. On y-axis, we have receiver output voltage. If there are variations in the incoming signal strength, it should be. If there are variations in incoming signal strength, we are supposed to get the output voltage constant. This is possible in ideal AGC. So we have to make use of the AGC circuit, which provides the characteristics similar to the ideal AGC circuit. Principle of AGC, a DC bias voltage derived from the detector is applied to selected number of RF, IF and mixer stages. The transconductance and gain of the devices used in those stages depends on the applied bias voltage. And hence the DC output of the wave recovered by the detector is filtered and fed back to the first IF amplifier as a bias voltage. The bias voltage modifies the gain of the amplifier relative to the signal at the antenna. When a strong signal is received, the detector DC output level is high and a large DC voltage is sent back to the IF stage to reduce the gain. For large signal, reduce the gain. For small signal, when the incoming signal is weak, smaller DC voltage from the detector is sent back to the IF amplifier to increase the gain. And hence, when the incoming signal is weak, a smaller DC voltage from the detector is sent back to the IF amplifier to increase the gain. At the minimum signal at the receiver input, loudspeaker output becomes inaudible and gets merged into noise. At the maximum input signal strength, loudspeaker output becomes tolerably large. To avoid this, automatic volume control or automatic gain control is used in all broadcast and radio telephone receivers. A properly designed AVC system reduces the amplitude variations due to the fading from high value 30 dB to 40 dB to a small value 3 dB to 4 dB. The net result is that the signal level at the output of the detector is relatively constant for either a weak signal or a strong signal. We want to provide a stabilized signal at the output. There are different methods of achieving AGC, four methods: simple AGC, delayed AGC, amplified AGC, amplified delayed AGC. The disadvantages with simple AGC are reduction of gain of amplifiers for weak signals, low signal to noise ratio, poor sensitivity of the receiver for weak signals. Now we'll see about the demodulation process in AM. It is a process of extracting the original information from the modulated signal. Demodulation is the process of recovering the original signal from the modulated signal. It is the reverse process of modulation. Demodulation is also known as detection. AM demodulation is the process of recovering the original message signal from the amplitude modulated signal. AM demodulation can be achieved using diode detector. This is a simple diode detector. This signal, it is an IF signal. Output of IF is applied to a detector. This IF signal is tuned, then it is induced into the secondary. Then we have the diode followed by a low pass filter. The main function of this circuit is to pick up the envelope. This AM wave is picked up here. It is passing through a diode. Diode clips up the negative half cycles, so positive half cycles along with the low frequency signal will be passed by the diode. And this low pass filter will pick up the low frequency signal. This output is the envelope. We will explain the process of diode detector here with the help of the waveforms. This is the AM wave which is there on IF. It is applied to diode detector. It consists of a diode followed by a low pass filter. During positive half cycles, the diode will be on. It passes the positive half cycles. All positive half cycles are passed by the diode. During negative half cycles of the incoming signal, the diode will be reverse biased. It will be off, so negative half cycles are filtered out. This is the output of the diode. It contains high frequency half cycles and a low frequency envelope. This low frequency envelope is the message signal. When it is applied to the low pass filter, this low pass filter passes the low frequency component. This low frequency is passed by the low pass filter. The high frequency half cycles are eliminated by the low pass filter. The working principle, the circuit diagram of simple diode detector is shown. Diode is the most common device used for AM demodulation. In the circuit shown, capacitor is C is small and R is large. The parallel combination of R and C is the load resistance across which the rectifier output voltage V0 is developed. Ideally, diode detectors produce an output signal that follows the envelope of the input signal. During positive half cycles of the input signal, the diode is forward biased. The capacitor C charges up rapidly to the peak value of the input signal. When the input signal falls below this value, the diode becomes reverse biased. The capacitor C discharges slowly through the load resistor R. The discharge process continues until the next positive half cycle comes. When the input signal voltage becomes greater than the voltage across the capacitor, the diode conducts again. This process is repeated. The capacitor voltage or detector output voltage is very nearly the same as the envelope of the AM. So this envelope of the AM wave we are picking up. This diode is passing half cycles and then charging process and then discharging process of the capacitor, we will be getting the envelope equal to the signal. Disadvantages, V0 in addition to being proportional to the modulating voltage, it has a DC component that is to be removed. A small ripple is also present that is to be removed. And hence we go for the practical diode detector. The unwanted components are to be removed with the help of the practical diode detector. Diode has been reversed so that negative envelope is demodulated. This has no effect on detection, but it does not ensure that the negative AGC voltage will be available. This is the circuit diagram of practical diode detector. IF signal is induced here. The diode is connected like this, and then we have R1, C1, R2, C2, R3, C3, and this AF output, there is a variation in the gain. So AGC is derived through R3 and C3. Working principle, the resistor R of the circuit have been split into two parts, R1, R2. It ensured that there is a series DC path to the ground for the diode. At the same time, a low pass filter has been added in the form of R1 and C1. The filter R1, C1 has the function of removing any RF ripple that might still be present. The capacitor CT is a coupling capacitor. The main function of CT is to prevent the diode DC output from the volume control R4. The combination of R3 C3 is a low pass filter which removes AF component, providing a DC whose amplitude is proportional to the carrier signal. This DC voltage is used for AGC. In this lesson, we have studied about functions of RF amplifier, choice of RF amplifier, choice of IF, factors influencing the choice of IF, what are the different values for IF systems, process of demodulation, we also discussed in detail. Now answer the quiz question. The standard IF value for FM receiver operating 88 megahertz to 108 megahertz is 10.7 megahertz, 455 kilohertz, 20 megahertz, D, 46 megahertz. The correct choice is 10.7 megahertz. The IF value for FM receiver is 10.7 megahertz. Second question. In radio receiver with simple AGC, option A, an increase in signal strength produces more AGC. The audio stage gain is normally controlled by AGC. Option C, the faster the AGC time contains, the more accurate the output. The highest AGC voltage is produced between the stations. The correct choice is option A. An increase in signal strength produces more AGC. It is used in the simple AGC circuit. Next question. The overall gain of the receiver is varied automatically with the changing signal strength of the received signal. It is called as automatic volume control, automatic gain control, automatic frequency control, both A and B. It is called automatic volume control or automatic gain control. Next question. The simple AGC circuit has the following disadvantage. Low SNR on weak signal, high SNR on weak signal, good sensitivity of the receiver on received weak signal, none of the above. Answer is low SNR on weak signal. This is also one of the limitations. Weak signal, we are supposed to get high SNR. Diode detector is used to detect option A, FM, option B, PM, option C, AM, option D, none. Diode detector is used to detect amplitude modulated signal. Now these are the various possible questions. State the functions of RF amplifier. Mention the choice of IF. What are the factors influencing the choice of IF? Define AGC. State the need for AGC. Explain about AGC. Explain the process of demodulation of AM using the circuit diagram. So all these questions we are supposed to answer after listening to this lesson.